We just reached 500,000 subscribers, guys! So that has to be celebrated with some real champagne. And there's no better way to celebrate this with the traditional Jannik catch!
Nice!
It's Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and welcome again to another Copycat Friday, a weekly series where we recreate an effect from a popular film, music video, or creator. Now, my Copycat t-shirt is in the laundry, but this one has a cat on it too, so we're good to go. Now, trick shots like the guys do over at Dude Perfect are not easy to recreate, which is why we're going to fake it. But before we start, I'd like to make a big shout out to Adorama, who are sponsoring us today. If you're looking for film equipment, then you need to head over to Adorama. Their professional team helps you with any questions when you're buying a new camera, lens, lighting kit, or anything else. To find out more, make sure to click the first link in the description below.
We don't have a basketball or a basketball ring, so that's what we're getting right now.
What you got, Lorenzo?
I got a basketball and a basketball ring.
Such a good intern.
Now we're back at the studio and now we can do the fun part, unboxing. Maybe we should start an unboxing challenge with all the goodies we get here.
There are two ways to shoot on a trick shot. The first one is from a realistic distance, but if you're just terrible at basketball, then you'll need to shoot. And we're gonna film everything from a tripod, as we're going to blend some clips together. Your first shot is you throwing the ball somehow in the right direction. Now you wanna avoid having the ball bounce back to you, so you might wanna ask someone else to catch it underneath. Then ask someone who can actually throw the ball in the loop, or you can use a ladder.
You suck, Lorenzo!
Say it again.
Then in Adobe Premiere Pro, you place your throwing shot on the bottom, and on top of that goes the shot where the ball goes into the loop. With the upper layer selected, you head over to the effects controls and take the pen tool under the opacity. Draw a mask around the loop, which will reveal the layer below. Now you'll need to find a way to match the movement of the ball from your first and second shot. And there you have faked your first trick shot, but it's probably not impressing anyone. And that's where the second technique comes in, where you stand at an unrealistic distance. The setup goes the same. You throw the ball from your spot, then get closer and throw the ball in the loop. Only now you also want to film a shot of the ball itself, floating in the air without too much motion blur. And that is why I'm throwing it gently in the air. Finally, you wanna run outside of the frame and get an empty shot in there as well. So there are four shots, which we'll now bring into Premiere Pro. The empty shot goes on the bottom, then the shot where you throw the ball, and on top of that, the ball going in the loop. Like before, we're going to draw a mask. This time it'll be around the two actions. Draw one around you throwing the ball and one on the other clip. Now where it goes into the loop, the distance is of course too far. We'll need to manually add a virtual ball on there. And that's where the fourth shot comes in. I'm gonna search for a point in that clip where the ball looks nice and clear to cut out. Then trim the clip to that point, right click and choose Add Frame Hold. Then with the pen tool, draw a mask around the ball. And now we're going to animate it, but first we'll need to nest it. You can do that by right clicking on it and choosing Nest. On this sequence, we can now add the transform effect. We're gonna position that ball with that effect so that it connects with my throw. Then create a keyframe for the position. If your ball goes into a distance, you also need to animate the scale, but that property shouldn't need much more tweaks. Then scrub forward at where the ball goes through the loop, and there you want to drag your fake ball to it and match its position as well with that. Next, we're going to pull the ball up somewhere in the middle of the animation, so that the ball goes into an arc. With the levers on the side, you can make it go in a smooth curve. Finally, disable to use composition's shutter angle and set one of your own like 180 degree, which gives you a natural motion blur. It might be that the movement already looks good. If not, then adjust the positions of your keyframes to make the ball go slower or faster. It takes some trials and errors to find the right spot. Catch!
Nice!
And that's how to fake those trick shots. Now you can find a link to all the gear that we used in the description below, and they all point to Adorama, our beloved partner. Thank you so much for watching, and like always, stay creative.
Damn it, my materials, my stuff.